We mentioned that the greedy approach of constructing a DHT leads to tree saturation, and the congestion happens at the node, which happens to map to a lot of clustered keys. The choral approach is very simple. Don't be greedy. What does that mean? Well, what it means is, in the greedy approach, when we have a key K, we try to store it in a node N whose node ID is equal to K. In the choral approach, use this as a hint, not an absolute. But you still have to have a method to the madness. If you're going to store it in some place different from N, then those who are trying to discover it have to have a method to the madness of where you've stored your key. We'll see how that is done. So the top level bit I want you to take away is that in the choral DHT, the get and put operations are satisfied by nodes that are different from the key K. The node ID N may not be close to key, and that's why the DHT that choral implements is called a sloppy DHT. And we'll talk about details of that in a minute. The rationale, of course, is you want to avoid tree saturation that comes about when a lot of keys map to a particular node ID. And also, in the process, what we want to do is spread the metadata overload so that no single node in this democratic process of helping one another is saturated or overloaded by being a good citizen. How does Choral do it? It has a novel key-based routing algorithm, which we'll describe. But the basis for that key-based routing algorithm is to compute the distance between the source of a get or a put operation and the destination for that get or put operation. The destination, by default, is going to be the node whose ID is equal to the key that you're looking for. So the distance between the source and the destination is the XOR distance, meaning if you do an exclusive OR, the bit pattern of the node ID for the source and the bit pattern for the node ID for the destination, that XOR of the two quantities give you the distance between the two nodes in the overlay network space. And the reason why you want to do an XOR is because an XOR operation, as opposed to, say, doing a subtraction, is going to be much faster. We do an XOR to find out the distance between the source and the destination that need to communicate. So, for instance, if the source address is 14 and the destination address is 4, remember that these are node IDs in the node ID space, which is at the level of the user. And if you do an XOR of that, you get 10. So 10 is the distance between the source 14 and the destination 4. The bigger the XOR value, the larger the distance between the source and the destination in the application namespace. And since we are dealing with fairly big numbers here, the node ID could be a 160-bit quantity, and that is the reason we want to use some simple operation that will get us the distance. XOR is a very quick operation to implement to get the distance between source and destination.